Have you ever wondered what an old house with a cinder block septic tank looks like? And have you ever wondered, can you have those still in Maryland? Well, today I want to get into it with you, show you what we're working with at this particular house and why cinder block tanks aren't really what you want to have on your property. So the very first thing that we notice is going to be these very strange 4-inch PVC pipes sitting right next to each other with a large metal lid right over there. Cinder block tanks and tanks made on site usually have some goofy stuff that doesn't quite look like it normally would. 4-inch lids inherently are not an issue, but when they're over top of where the septic system is supposed to be, that usually means somebody put something in that's not standard. The traditional size in our area for a proper concrete tank is 6 inches. Now, the manhole riser, that is what we would normally see, but once we pop it open, we might get a little bit more of an interesting look into the tank. So I'm gonna pop this open and I'm gonna show you what I'm talking about. So the very first thing that we see when we pop open the tank, one, is we have quite a large square lid and we have a bunch of bricks underneath of our concrete ceiling. We can see over here, that's one seam and the other seam. So we know that this is cinder block, but you can see that we've got soil coming in through the seams there and right where the outlet line is. That orange pipe that we see right here, that is terracotta piping. This is a baffle. Now they've gone ahead and taken what looks to be ABS, 3 inches in size, put a little, you know, sweep onto it, shoved it into the pipe to create a new baffle. Now, we refer to this as a candy cane baffle. We can see that we have a few issues with this particular tank, right? The first thing is there are visible gaps in the wall and there's soil and root intrusion coming in. Cinder block tanks are prone to leakage, to structural integrity problems. So it's not surprising that we see soil, we see cracks, we see roots. These are all basically par for the course. In the state of Maryland, even if the system was permitted back, you know, back in the day, you're not allowed to have them anymore. And the reason why is that because they were made on site, there was not as much oversight. The construction standards weren't as rigorously vetted, so we don't know for sure that people did everything correctly. So you end up running into more issues of collapses or people getting hurt or things falling in, squirrels, animals, people, lawnmowers, etc. That's not a good time. Most of these systems also would have a dirt floor, which would inherently mean that they are leaking. If you're having a cinder block tank inspected or put on your property, just know you're gonna end up replacing it. The next main concern that we have is gonna be that candy cane baffle. And the reason why is that the candy cane baffle, which is just that little swoopy part, right? What happens is gases can get trapped on the absorption system, distribution box. It'll cause further decay of the box itself. And it can also cause issue and injury to the pumper whenever they pump down the tank. Now, this particular one is just a regular old candy cane that's put in there and it's just slid into the pipe. It's not actually glued or any kind of adhesive or sealant was put in there. So it's not gonna actually hold the gas, which, not the end of the world, but they need to replace the tank. So that baffle's kind of a moot point entirely. Cinder block tanks are most prevalent on homes, at least in our area, but basically between 1940 and 1965. That's usually where you'll see most of them. You'll see more of these systems in your Western Maryland, more towards the Potomac, so your Montgomery counties, Frederick counties. You might see it in parts of Howard County, but they're not as common. Most of them have been replaced or collapsed by this point. So if you're buying a house in the 70s to now, the chances of you coming across a cinder block tank are almost next to none. I have seen it a couple times in the years, but it's not a super common prevalent experience that most people have. The main thing with these things is anytime you have a cinder block tank, you have to get it replaced. It's not safe. It's not a good idea to keep them in place at all. Usually, if you're not purchasing the house, the only other way that you'll come across this being an issue is when you go to pull a permit for an addition or a major renovation to the property, right? So let's just say for sake of argument, you have a main home. In that house, you have a 2-car garage right next to it. Let's say that you want to make your 4-bedroom house into a 5-bedroom house by converting that garage into a master suite. Well, if you go to pull the permit to make that garage into a finished livable area, the county is going to require an inspection on the property. Basically, it'll be a regulated inspection, at which point, because the regulated inspection does not allow cinder block tanks,
your tank will be flagged, and then you will have to replace it prior to receiving any permits or the green light to start construction on your property for that garage. Now, let's just say that you're not going through this renovation project. The state's not gonna come knocking on your door asking, hey, do you have a cinder block tank? Do you have a metal tank? Do you have a concrete tank? What kind of septic tank do you have? The only time the state gets involved is with permits and with inspections for a real estate transfer. When I say the term state, usually with permits, it's gonna be county specific, but because Maryland state has been getting on the counties, now the counties are gonna be more aggressive because of the state, right? So it's just a little bit of a bureaucratic thing. So if you have a cinder block tank already on the property, don't panic, but you gotta know that that thing's gonna end up getting replaced the moment you go to sell that property or do any major repair work to the property. Now, if you're fixing, you know, a bathroom, the odds of them causing a septic inspection is basically next to none. It usually is going to be bedroom increase. It's going to be major reworks to the floor plan. Maybe you want to put a garage. Sometimes I've even seen, like, Anne Arundel County for perspective, I've seen them get fussy about decks. Specifically, they'll make you do an inspection prior to even issuing the permit for a deck. Baltimore County will do that for pools, right? So if you want to do an above ground pool, below ground pool, they will force you to go ahead and get a septic inspection prior to the issuance of a permit to install that pool. Now, most septic systems will work even if they're falling apart, right? This particular system, right? Walls are falling apart. Homeowners lived here for God knows how long, and they've claimed to never have had a problem, which very well could be true, but it's not the way that it's supposed to be. And that's why we have a little bit of an issue. So I thought it was an interesting one. I don't come across cinder block tanks that often anymore. Most of them have been replaced, and I think they're fun, right? It's always interesting stuff to look at, and I figured I would share it with you. If you gained any value out of this, if you found this interesting or informative in any way, hit that like button, hit subscribe. I post videos every day on the World of Well and Septic, and I look forward to talking to you guys tomorrow.